Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now we are going to see how we can find R&S configuration of biphenyl compound. We are going to see step by step procedure and its variants. What is inside this video? At first, we will see how the chiral axis create chirality in biphenyl compound and some examples and symmetry in biphenyl. Later, we will see how we can find R&S configuration, and I given some example for you to practice yourself. The chirality will be a wonderful thing you might felt without knowing what is chirality. Let us understand it by shoe. You might wonder why left shoe don't fit in right leg. Same way right leg don't fit in left shoe, because they are three dimensionally different. Because left shoe not equal to right shoe in terms of space. The space is 3D space, which is called stereo. The chemistry is stereochemistry. Technically they are called chiral. Most of the time they are mirror image of each other. They call enantiomers in chemistry. So you should know chiral mean three dimensionally different structures. The chemicals also can be chiral. It classified into four types: 0 dimension, 1 dimension, 2 dimension and 3 dimension. The 0 dimension is chiral center, everybody knows, carbon attached with 4 different species. Then chiral axis, which is 2 perpendicular plane create the chiral axis, which is our interest today. Then chiral plane, a particular plane create the chirality. The spiraling of compound create the chirality, mostly helices and DNA. Today our whole interest is about chiral axis, mostly the biphenyl compound. We are going to see how the chirality is created, how we can find R&S configuration. Let us understand the biphenyl first. Biphenyl is a compound where two benzenes are attached through single bond and you have ortho substitutions. How they really look is, they are mutually perpendicular plane. One benzene and another benzene is like perpendicular to each other. We can draw in our paper through wedge and dot structure. One benzene is on plane, another benzene half is above the plane, half is below the plane. The bromine is below the plane, CH3 is above the plane. So you have to imagine a molecule in 3D to master the R&S configuration. Then you should know how the biphenyl is chiral. You might wonder there is no chiral carbon, how it can be chiral? Because chiral axis create the chirality, it makes it optically active. Suppose you have the biphenyl attachment with 2 methyl and bromine, technically it will be equal to chiral center. You cannot directly correlate it, but technically equal. The chirality created from chiral axis. That's why you don't need 4 different substituents. Any 2 is enough to create the chirality. Here the concept is, without chiral carbon, chirality is possible. The biphenyl chirality due to its chiral axis. I have to warn you, you have to check the chirality before you get into R&S. If it is chiral only, you can say R&S. Achiral means there is no meaning of it. So if you look at the A, it is not chiral because all hydrogens are there. It has 2 perpendicular plane of symmetry. 2 benzene rings have plane and it reflect each other. Next thing also same, CH3, the plane goes through CH3 and it is not chiral. Again see 2 CH3, the plane again goes to CH3, it is not chiral. If you look at the D, it is a planar compound, 2 carbon fused one, definitely it is not chiral. If you look at the E, it is chiral because 2 different attachment in the same benzene. So you can say chiral. If you look at F, you might think it can have plane of symmetry. No, because of perpendicular nature, it don't have. It is also chiral. If you look at the G, again it is chiral because of normal chiral carbon. So before we get into that, you should know whether the compound is chiral or not. Then the important deciding factor, viewing side. So you have to master the viewing side. Viewing side means you are looking at the molecule in the particular angle. Here I shown the man standing near the molecule. Then you have to guess which is right side, which is left side, which is top, which is bottom. Here right side is chlorine, left side is hydrogen, top is bromine, bottom is CH3. How we can represent in paper? The thick line is the viewing line, thin line is the back side. We write it like tetrahedral carbon. So you have to write right side, left side, top and bottom. So you have to master the viewing side. How we can find R&S? First you have to design the viewing angle where priority of front side is greater than back side. Then you have to go for CAP rule. When finding the priority by CAP rule, go with atomic number, then atomic mass. Then you have to find the orientation. Clockwise minute is R, anti-clockwise minute is S. New name is P and M. It is plus and minus. The new chiral compound have this kind of naming. Then the important thing you should know is changing the viewing angle don't change the results. Here I given by the example, you are looking at the molecule. The right side of you is OH, left side of you is hydrogen. You are seeing from that side, then top of you is chlorine, bottom is bromine. So thicker side is H and OH, thin side is chlorine and bromine. If you look at the priority, OH get first, hydrogen is second, third is bromine, fourth is chlorine. So if you look at the orientation, it will be anti-clockwise. You should know one important thing where front hydrogen get higher priority than back side chlorine and bromine. So you should master the viewing angle, master the orientation. That's how you find R&S. Then we should know the fact, changing the viewing angle don't change the results of the same molecule. Here I given the same molecule, you are viewing from different side. The first one you are seeing from bromine and chlorine side. The second one you are seeing from hydrogen and OH side. The thicker line varies. First one chlorine and bromine get thicker line. Second one hydrogen and OH thicker line. The right side is bromine. The second one left side is bromine. So if you find the orientation, you will have anti-clockwise on both sides. So change the viewing angle won't change the results. Then, like any other chiral compound, the biphenyls having mirror image have opposite configuration. Here I given the biphenyl which having mirror image relationship. The left side one, if you look at it, bromine right side, chlorine left side, hydrogen top, OH below. The viewing side is chlorine and bromine. So if you find the orientation, it is anti-clockwise. The right side molecule you are seeing from the hydrogen and OH side, which is the thicker line. Then you go with chlorine and bromine. So if you find the orientation, it will be clockwise direction, it is R. The compounds are having mirror image relationship will have opposite configuration. Then change of substituent can change the configuration. Here I given the compound where chlorine is below, chlorine is above. If you look at the viewing side, the positions are changing. That's why you have change in configuration. In the first one, chlorine is left side, the second one, chlorine is right side, which will interchange the configuration from anti-clockwise to clockwise. The same thick line is front side, thin line is back side. The orientation of left one is S, right one is R. So change of substituent will result in the change in configuration. Then I given some example to practice yourself. Here I given the 4 different biphenyl compound. The first one nitro and acid one. The nitro get higher priority than acid based on atomic number. The viewing side all are same. The first one will have anti-clockwise. The second one, if you look at it, the bromine you have to eliminate. You have to go till amine and hydrogen. So apply with the priority rule. So if you do it, you have clockwise direction R. The third one is like chiral carbon. Iodine gets higher priority than bromine. So you'll have configuration clockwise R. The third one is interesting. You have substituent different in the OH position to Cl. Acid to acid chloride. Same CAP rule apply. You have to decide the viewing angle. So you get the priority. You have the configuration of R there. So practice yourself to master the concept. Let us summarize the points what we've seen so far. First you have to check the chirality before find R&S. Then if you look at the orientation, if it is R mean it is P. The chiral axis create the chirality in biphenyl compound. But before check into the R&S configuration, you have to find the chirality. When you find the orientation, clockwise mean R, or new name P, anti-clockwise mean S, new name is M. Then while finding, you have to master the viewing angle. You have to imagine the molecule in 3D. Here I given some example. You have to find if it is the same substituent, it is not chiral. If it is a different substituent but in perpendicular plane, it is also chiral. The substituent and the second position also chiral. So you have to master the chirality. The one important fact you have to know is changing the viewing angle won't change the results. That's all from this video. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. If you really like my video, do subscribe and share.